गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 15. सो व्हाट हैपन आफ्टर दैट, द वाटर लेवल वॉज अंडर कंट्रोल बाय द मॉर्निंग ऑफ 3rd January. सो ऑल ऑफ देम दे टुक 2 hours रेस्ट इन रोटेशन, मीन्स फर्स्ट पर्सन वॉज रेस्टिंग एंड देन आफ्टर दैट अनदर वन. बट देयर स्टिल वॉज अ लीक समवेयर बिलो द वाटर लाइन एंड अपॉन चेकिंग द बोट रिप स्ट्रक्चर was badly broken down till the base of the ship. The whole section of starboard was held together with a few cupboard partitions, means they used cupboard partition to repair the starboard. The ship's condition was so bad that it would not make it till Australia, means the condition was so worse that they were not able to reach till Australia. The narrator checked the charts and calculated that there were 2 small islands a few kilometers to the east, okay, and then one of them was Isle Amsterdam, which was a French scientific base. Their only hope was to search and reach that island, but only if the wind and the sea do not cause further damage, else their chances were quite low. The wave had destroyed the ship's auxiliary engine. Here you can see the pic of auxiliary engine which is used in the ship. Then what happened after 36 hours of continuous pumping? On 4th of January, the water was only a few centimeters left to be pumped out. But still, they had to pump out the water which was coming inside the ship. They could not set sail on the main mast. They hoisted the storm jib and sailed towards the 2 small islands because they were not able to reach Australia. They had their first meal in 2 days. And what was that? Some corned beef and cracker biscuit which Mary found somewhere. Then the rest period was short-lived because black clouds, they built up around 4 p.m. Then the wind was now 40 knots. And the sea was getting higher. The weather got worse, and by the early morning of January 5, the situation was bad. I have used one term over here, that is 40 knots. So 40 knots is equal to 46.03 miles per hour. It is a navigational sort of measurement. Okay, the term knot dates from the 17th century. When sailors measured the speed of their ship by using a device called a common log. This device was a coil of rope with uniformly spaced knots attached to a piece of wood shaped like a slice of pie. Now, when the narrator went to comfort his children, his son asked him whether they are going to die. He tried to assure him that they would make it, means it is not going to happen in that manner. His son replied that they were not afraid to die till they all were together. A small child is saying like that. This filled the narrator with a determination to fight back. He made efforts to protect the weakened starboard side. He used an improvised sea anchor, which is made up of heavy nylon rope, and he used 22-liter plastic barrel of kerosene. That same evening, the narrator and his wife, they sat holding hands of each other and they believed that their end was near. Okay, then the ship made it through the storm, and by the morning of January 6, the narrator tried to get reading on the sextant. What is sextant? It is an instrument. Here you can see picture of that. He worked with wind speeds, drift and current, and also calculated their position. They were in 150,000 kilometers area of ocean and looking for a 65 kilometer wide island. While the narrator was still thinking, his daughter Sue, Suzanne, joined him. She was in pain. And then what happened? The left side of her head was swollen and her blackened eyes had narrowed down to slits. She gave him a card which she made herself. On the front of the card was a cartoon image of her parents with words written about them being funny people and then how they made her laugh. On the inside of the card, she told them how she loved both of them and she also thanked them. This made the narrator realize that they had to make it to the island. Narrator then rechecked his calculations. They lost the main compass and were using the spare one, which was not corrected for magnetic variations. Then he estimated the influence of the westerly currents which flow through the Indian Ocean. Around 2 p.m., he went on deck and asked Larry to steer the wheel to 185 degrees. He felt if they were lucky enough, they would see the island by 5 p.m. Then he went below and slept. He woke up around 6 p.m. in the evening and it was quite dark that time. He thought that they might have missed the island. Now he started worrying about how they would tackle the westerly wind more as the ship wasn't capable to sail more. His son came and asked him for a hug. His daughter also followed. The narrator asked that why was he getting a hug? His son replied that he was the best daddy in the world and also called him the best captain. Then narrator replied that he was afraid. Then Suzanne told him that they had found the island which was as big as a battleship. The narrator rushed to the deck and gave a sigh of the relief. They could see the complete outline of Isle Amsterdam. There was a bleak piece of volcanic rock in front of them. It had a little vegetation. It was the most beautiful island in the world. They moored the ship at some distance from the shore and the next morning, 28 inhabitants of the Amsterdam island helped them to move on the shore of land. As he felt the land again on his feet, he thought of his crewmen and his wife and children. He also thought of his 7-year-old daughter who was injured badly. She had to go through 6 minor operations after that to remove the blood clot in her head. His son, who never gave up, was not afraid to die. So with this, we have completed our chapter. I hope you all have understood. Thank you.